Welcome back to Car Diagnostic Software. In the previous video, I showed you how to download and install the specialized software FDRS, and in this video, I show you how to use it. In my hand are VCM2 and VNCI devices. However, when using a VNCI device, there will be many features of the software that you cannot use, so I will choose VCM2 device. Make sure your connections are not interrupted during work. The port to connect to the car is right below. When a successful connection with the vehicle is made, the indicator light will appear on the VCM2 device. You can easily recognize it. Then connect to your laptop. Next is the main part of today's video, that is using FDRS software. In this video, I will use a non-dealer account to perform tasks on the 2021 Ford Ranger. After successful account logging, you need to select the device you use. Here I use VCM2 device, so I will select it and click OK. This icon will change from red to green when you connect the device successfully. On the screen will appear how you can identify your vehicle. You can use two ways. The first, and also the way I use the most, is Red VIN Auto. Besides, you can enter your car VIN if you remember them. Below is a history of the most recent vehicle identification times. Next, click Go to perform the process of reading vehicle information. Vehicle information is displayed under the Vehicle Information tab. The boxes will be annotated with different colors. Gray is unresponsive box. Green is the box that responded and activated. Yellow is storage DTCs. With toolbox tag. These are all possible tools for diagnostic testing. When not selected in each box, the list will change continuously. This location the tools need to be downloaded to use. You can understand that FDRS can be used online. Next, with the self-test tab, you can do the error reading here. With this function, you can select up to 5 boxes. And here I will do error reading for BCM and PCM. It is easy to see the difference here. It is red for BCM box and blue for PCM box. This means there is an error with the BCM box and not with the PCM box. Click here to view damage details for the BCM box. Read data with PCM box. Entering data logger. These are all actual values you can choose to see details about. And here is the display result of the actual value. Finally, I will introduce an interesting feature of the FDRS software, that is that it can activate the actuator. I will activate the low beam and it will work as you do in the software. Okay, recently, I have guided you to use some functions of FDRS software on Ford Ranger 2021 with this non-dealer account. There are still some functions that cannot be used, but it is quite complete and useful. If you find this video useful, don't forget to like and sub to my YouTube channel.